Hi, to all esteemed members of this channel, thank you very much. Today is another day that we take on another new session. From what we've been doing in the preparation of bills of quantities, so far so good, we've covered a considerable ground of items. I would like us to continue with from where we left. We have been doing what we call reinforcement, and I want to say that for the new members who are getting this video for the first time, this is a channel that has been doing what we call preparation of bills of quantities, amongst other items in relation to quant surveying. For the catch-up videos, you'll find them at the description button of this particular session. I would like us to take it straight away to where we left. We have done reinforcement bars, and today I would like us to do what we call finish with the item of BRC. So if you want to measure the BRC, which is in full is called British Reinforced Concrete, that means that is now the mesh which is being used to do the reinforcement for the ground floor slab. As usual, I would like to show what that is and how it's done, and then we take it off in regard to this very plan that we've been using. Again, for my new members, the drawing for the plan or the drawing for the items that we are doing here is attached to the community wall. You'll find it there for your reference. All right, so we'll take it on. I would like just to show an image of the BRC, how it's looking like, and then we'll continue with the item of how to measure it. So normally, I would also like to reiterate that normally construction is a process. So once you've done the items, for instance, site clearance, you've done the filling, for instance, what you're seeing here, this is now the filling in hardcore. So once you've done that, then there are other processes which are involved, and that include laying of the polythene sheeting, which is the DPM, and then just on top of it, you do what we call the spacers, and after the spacers, you do what we call the BRC. So BRC is basically meant to reinforce the ground floor slab. So I'd like us to do it, take it off from the drawing that we've done, and also see from that particular drawing which is the section that you need to consider so that you are able to find the particular specification of that BRC which is meant for that particular drawing. So this is exactly how it looks like. It's basically reinforcement bars, so of course of the smaller diameters that have been linked together to form squares that is suitable for reinforcement of a ground floor slab. So back to work, back to our estimation. So this is how to take it off. So from our plan, if you need to get the details of the availability of the reinforcement or the BRC and how to do that, then normally this is what is expected of you. You should go to the details. Maybe you go to the details of the ground floor, the strip footing. From there, you can always find whether it's been annotated. That is option one. Option two, you can check on the foundation layout. Normally, you can find it provided there. So in this case, I'm looking at this, and it seems not to be part of the descriptions or the specifications on the plan. Then you go option two, check on your foundation strip footing. If it's not there, then you go to these are the details. So at the details, it's only shown that you have 150 millimeters thick of the ground floor. This is the slab. But then the rest of the details, including the type of reinforcement that is done for it, has not been given. Okay. So should you fail to find it in any of those options that I have given, then the next alternative is to you to get to check to the notes at the notes. All right, so from the note side you might find it. If it's not there, like for instance I'm seeing in this point we only have note one, note two talking about the machine strength of the stones, number three talking about the bars, the reinforcement bars which we have measured. And next, I cannot see it there. So from that point, that is when you have the ability, or you can go ahead and make an assumption in regard to the type of reinforcement bar that I mean the BRC which can be used for that particular plan. But how do you go about the same? You can only assume only when you have an idea. There are various types which will be your assignment. There are various types of BRC. We have A98. Of course, the specifications are normally given depending on the strength. Okay, the most commonly used is A142, which weighs about 2.22 kgs per square meters, which is most generally used for most of the reinforcement of the ground floor slabs. So that is what I would like us to assume for this case, right? So as usual, we get to do the description. So this will be BRC reinforcement. Reinforcement bars, all right. So from there, that is basically just a title. Of course, I'll make it bold as usual. And then now my item F is going to be A142. That is now the specifications. Okay, BRC mesh. Okay, to ground floor slab. So basically, you give your description based on the specific item that you're going to use and also the location. And you can go further by stating weighing 2.22 kgs per square meters. Okay. All right. Including laps and so on. So that is basically how you like it laid on the plan or on the slab before casting. So once you have that, then this should be measured in square meters. That is what the standard methods of measurements states in square meters. And of course, the area. Area is equivalent to what you have done for the ground floor slab. So that is what you equate that particular area to, all right? Ground floor slab was 115 square meters. So basically, that is what is expected of you to estimate BRC. So once you have done that, then in this session as well, I would like us to do what you call the formwork. Okay, the formwork for the concrete items that we've done, right? So that is also an item that I would like us to take off. So the next one is straight away called formwork. So let's take off the formwork and see how it's done. Formwork, we are going to do formwork basically having understood the essence of formwork, basically to support the wet concrete before it gains sufficient strength so that it can carry itself. So we are going to do the formwork only to the concrete items. So concrete item one that is going to require formwork is the strip footing. So how do we go about that, right? So first, this is now item G. So we are going to do to vertical sides of the strip footing. So I always recommend that you maintain the order so that if the first one was the strip footing, you don't start with the ground floor slab in the next takeoff, the list of items, just for the purpose of orderliness. To the vertical sides of a strip footing, this is stated by the standard methods of measurements that you need to do it in square meters. All right, for those of you who are wondering, there is a list which we did. The list is talking about all the substructure items plus their units and also the sections where you can find those items from the standard methods of measurements. This is a session on its own, and it's one of the videos under my channel which you are always free to check from it and get a catch up, especially for my new members. For those who've been there, I'm certain that you've taken notes of this rule somewhere, a summarized one, so that it's easier for you to carry forward. So let's continue. All right, so once we've seen that, then we get back to what we are supposed to be doing now. So first of all, after we've noted all the items, we start with what we call the concrete work. I mean formwork for formwork with the vertical sides of the strip footing. It should be done in square meters. And then for what we need to consider in that particular calculation is the sides. So we get the length, of course, to our side here is where we do all our takeoffs. So we just note, I would like to, let me just get to it. It's on this particular line. I can always use, Excel is very flexible. So I can always use this particular point. So I can use this side to calculate formwork to footing. All right. So when I have that, I'll just get an equal sign, and of course get back to the items that we've done under the concrete. This is where we got the concrete. So we need to find out where exactly we did our calculation. So we get the length. After we have the length, so this is where we got the length. Actually, under the blinding, it was 4.9 on the length, and then width was 2.4, giving us a total of 14.6. So the total length was 14.6 for the strip footing. So we get that, and then you multiply by the thickness of the strip footing, right? Because we are going to have the formwork at the sides. So this is the total length. Then you multiply by the thickness. And thickness of the strip footing, you get back to the details which we had done here. Yes, so this is the detail for the strip footing. The thickness is 200 millimeters. So that is what we are supposed to use to get our area for the formwork. So it's 0.2, and then we multiply by 2. Because you're going to have formwork on both sides, on the opposite sides of the footing. So the formwork to the footing is giving us to be 5.84 square meters, right? So that is 6 square meters. Then the next item that I will also want us to do, the formwork 2, is now the next concrete item which we had. So this is item H. And the next formwork to be calculated is formwork to sides, vertical sides of column bases. Right? So you can always talk about ditto. Ditto simply means as said above, so that you don't have to repeat all the elements of your description. Ditto to sides of. Talk about ditto column bases. So you've basically repeated all the items that you've described. So this is now column bases, right? So as usual, I will also want us just to do the takeoff to the side, to this other point. So this is a column bases, right? So we had a column base schedule which we had done depending which categorized all the items for their sizes and the numbers. So that is what we are supposed to have. So taking note of the column bases and how they look like and how the column the formwork should be laid. So first of all, it's important that you are able to relate what we mean by the when we say formwork to the sides, vertical sides of the column bases. So basically, this is how it looks like. Of course, you are intending to pour your base on this point, or the concrete for the base at this within that particular formwork. So it means you need to get the total length or all of the sides. Okay, if it's not a square, But then the underlying principle is you need to get the area of that formwork. That is one. But how do you go about that? The safest way is for you to get the length of formwork all around that particular base, which basically means length plus width, then you multiply by 2. Basically, how you'd find the perimeter of that particular base. After that, then you also need to multiply by it by the thickness of the bases. So once you understand that, then you are able to take off any other type of a base or of a formwork that you might encounter. So once that is properly understood, then we get back to our bills of quantities. So for the column bases that we have, there are quite a number. So I'll just do here, this is B1, then I'll do B2, and actually after B1 there is a CB1, and then there is B2 and B3. Yeah, I believe they are of those three types, but let's just confirm so that we see actually they are here, they are. And in fact, we can just have this copied here as it is. So again, to my new members, these bases, you can always confirm and count them off the plan, the foundation layout plan, and you make a schedule. A schedule basically tells you the number of you identify the bases, you give the sizes and so on, so that you have them all in place. So from what we've seen, okay, I would also like to add, let's see from here if we had, oh, of course, so this is better. So we need the all of the those are three items. I mean length, width and the depth. So I'll just copy all of them and bring them here. Copy them there so that we have length, width and the depth. All right. So for us to get the area of the formwork, as you've seen from that illustration just a moment ago, you will take the perimeter. And how do you get the perimeter? So it's a length, then you add to width, all right, then you multiply that by 2. So that is basically getting you getting the perimeter of that particular base. So the formula that we've input is for the perimeter. After the perimeter, then you multiply by the depth so that you get the area, or the, you can call it the girth of the formwork, whichever way that you'd wish to refer it to. As long as you are heading towards getting the area of that particular formwork, there is never any problem with that. So that is what the area is coming to. But then there is something else we are forgetting, which is the number. All right. So I'll also add it here. Let me see if it's also part of this. Yeah. So I'll also copy the numbers of the bases so that you get the area of 1, and then you multiply by the total. So this is the number of the bases. All right, so this is the formula that we've got, and then we also multiply by the number of the bases so that we have all the areas for all the bases in place. And when you copy all that, Excel makes your work so easy. So when you copy that particular formula, just click on one cell. When you have that positive sign, dark positive sign, then you just scroll downwards. It will copy all the formula just below it. So this gives us the area for all the bases. And because we need it for bases assorted area, then we'll just sum up what we've got. And this is what we shall find. Right? So equal sign, then you type a sum, and then you give it a range. Just that simple. So the area is coming to be 62 square meters. Right? So this is 62 square meters. Well, so far so good. Then we go to the next item, and that is stub columns, or the foundation columns. All right, so this is also ditto. Ditto. Foundation columns. This should also be done in square meters. And how do you do that? the same procedure that we've done for our bases, the formwork to the bases, is what we will adopt, right? So having done the schedule, that makes our work even easier. So we get just to the site as we are doing for the other items. This is a formwork, column bases formwork. So you have to make sure that all your items are indicated properly. So this is supposed to be W, so that it shows formwork. These are column bases. Then we have a column schedule just here. So in the same way, we'll copy all these items that we have, including the length, width, and the height, right? So you can see how much these the workings relate. So once you have a preceding work that was well arranged, then it's normally an easier task moving forward. All right, so this is now column formwork. So I'm also forgetting again the number which I need to have here, and the number is this one. All right, so what I'll do, that is the number, just copy them as well and put it there. So this is the number. Right, so as usual, for us to get that particular area, we'll get the perimeter. So that you can call it perimeter, or you can call it the gap, just distance all round that column. So once you've added them, which is the length plus the width, then multiply by 2. So it's that one. You add to 0.2, and then you multiply by 2. So once you've multiplied by 2, you shall have got the girth of the formwork around the column. Then you multiply by the height of that particular column, and then you multiply by the number. Okay, you copy that particular formula, and then you sum, get the sum of the areas of all the columns that you've done. Okay, and that comes to that comes to 34.2. So very quickly, I'll just want to show you in a minute how that formwork to the sides of the columns is looking like. So looking at the illustration, this is a typical example of how the formwork to the sides of the columns is supposed to be laid. So looking at it, you notice that you have a box like element, right? So it means all the sides you are supposed to have formwork. So basically, when you have a column like the one that we've done of 500 by 200, then you need to get the whole girth. So you add the 500 plus 200 plus 200 plus another 500. Then you multiply by the height. So basically, that is how you are supposed to go about your work concerning a calculation of area of formwork to the sides of stub columns. So that gives us an area of 35 square meters. Well done. So we go on to ground beams, a formwork to sides of the ground beams. Okay, so we'll just copy this and paste it here. This is now item J, detour, and then it's now ground beams. Yes, in this case, I'll start straight away by showing an example of how that is looking like from an illustration point of view, and then we get back to estimate it very quickly. So here we are. This is how it looks like. Basically, we are using timber, or in our estimation, we are talking about sawn formwork timber for the ground beams, and also to the other items that we've done so far. So basically this is how it's looking like. Our beam is supposed to be, concrete for the beam is supposed to be poured inside that formwork box that has been prepared. And therefore, you notice that of our essence is to get the area of the formwork to the sides, side one and side two, only that. So it means you need to get the total length. Once you have your total length, and then you multiply by the thickness of the ground beam that you have, then you multiply by two. So it's as precise as that. So we get back to our element, the what we've been doing, and we take it off quite fast. So here we are. For the ground beams, we had got the length while we were doing what you call estimation for the concrete. So this is where we are. So we had got it. Let's see what we had calculated. Let's see what we had calculated in our previous working. All right. So ground beams, I can see it here. From our calculation, the length is this. This is the length, width, and the draw and the depth. So for us to get that formwork, we'll just continue what to the side the way we've been doing. So I want to do it here. So this is the formwork. Formwork to sides of ground beam. So once you've noted that, so our length, we had calculated that particular length. I would like us to, so the length is that, and then we multiply by the side, which is the depth, and the depth is 0.3, and then we should multiply by 2, because from the illustration, you notice that you should put the formwork to both sides of the ground beam only. So it's the total length, then you multiply by the width of the girthon, either side, side one and side two, and that is it. So that area is supposed to be 8.76 rounded up to 9 square meters. So far so good. Let's see what is left out. After the ground beams, then we have to the edges of the ground floor slab. Okay, so we need also another set of formwork to ground floor slab edges. So that one is supposed to be done in linear meters. Unlike the rest of the items, for formwork to the sides of the ground floor slab, it stated that we need to measure it in linear meters, in stages of 75 millimeters. So I would like to insert, you remember that even as we are doing our bills of quantities using this Excel, then we also take chance to learn our editing, to improve our editing skills for the using the Excel. So how do you insert a row for this case? So you highlight that, then you copy, right? Then click on where you want to insert it on top. So I want to insert it just on top of the cell that I've highlighted. That is now row number 46. So click anywhere on that, especially towards the end, and then you right click. So when you right click, you will get insert copied cells. And because I don't want interference with whatever I have to my calculations, I will highlight it now, right? I will highlight it, then I deselect the items within here, and then I want to now delete the rest of the items to the side, right? So when I, so that it doesn't interfere with what I have done, or so I want to delete that one that way, so that there is no any other element which is going to interfere with what I've done to the working on this side aside. So I will, so this is going to be to edges of the ground floor slab, girth. So for you to get that range of your selection of formwork to the edges of the slab, then you need to refer to the thickness of that particular slab. Okay, and because it's supposed to be, yeah, actually I've just noticed here that we need to input more description here. So looking at our description, looking at our details, which you can find from the columns here, because I saw this is the ground floor slab. It's 150 millimeters in thickness. Okay, so that should be reflected in your description of the ground floor slab at the concrete level. So this is 150 millimeters thick ground floor, thick ground floor slab. So that is now very complete. Okay, so to edges of a ground floor slab, girth exceeding 75 millimeters thick but not exceeding 150 millimeters. Okay, so that is how you need to describe formwork to the edges of the slab. Because it's 150, then that means it's now past the 75, so it's exceeding already the first 75 category millimeters category, but it's not going past the 150 millimeters in terms of the width or the girth. And then this is supposed to be in linear meters. So basically, once you've pinpointed your the unit of measurement, your description is in place as usual, we then focus on getting our length. So for us to get the length, then we need to get back to where we calculated the ground floor slab. That is alternative one. Alternative two is you going back to what we call where we did, let me see. Yes, so following up from what we did when we were getting the area for the ground floor slab, basically when we need to get that total length, then we need just to get perimeter of the ground floor slab. So I would like to also show just in a quick illustration so that you see exactly what we mean by the formwork to the edges. So this is a typical floor that has been done. Of course, this is the concrete, and to the side you can see what has been set as the formwork. So the formwork to the edge is basically set to contain this particular concrete in shape, and also to make it to allow it gain sufficient strength, just as we had discussed. So this is what we have, and then so once you've understood that, then we go straight to what we are supposed to carry out in our estimation. So of course I've noted that we need to get the perimeter of the ground floor slab. So we get back to our working, and we'll copy this. So this is now going to be formwork to edges instead of side, to edges of slab. Okay, so this is equals to, we need to get the perimeter. So that is basically a formula of length plus width, then we multiply by 2. So we add that, and then we add to that one, and then we multiply by 2. So it's length plus width times 2. So it's basically a simple calculation of perimeter. That total length comes to 43.2, and that is going to be 44 meters. Okay. So that is all about formwork and all about BRC reinforcement. So that brings us to, yeah, so that brings us to the end of our coverage, where we were supposed to do finish up on the reinforcement, and we've done so by doing the BRC reinforcement, and then we've also covered formwork to completion. So there are a few elements that are left concerning the substructure works, which we are intending to cover in our next upcoming session. So for today, I would like to call it done, and I would like to be very much grateful to you for watching up to this point. And I'm confident from the comments that I'm receiving that this channel is at least educating you, and you are also learning a lot from it. So please subscribe, share as much as you want so that it reaches more people. And of course, do not forget to turn on the notification button so that as soon as these videos drop, you are always kept in the loop. Thank you very much. Have a great time till we meet again in our next session that is coming very soon. Thank you very much. Bye bye.